गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दिस क्लास ऑन डाइज एंड देयर क्लासिफिकेशन। यू मस्ट हैव कम अक्रॉस ए नंबर ऑफ एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ डाइज, राइट फ्रॉम डाइंग वेरियस सब्सट्रेट्स लाइक पेपर, लेदर, फर, हेयर, ड्रग्स, कॉस्मेटिक्स, वैक्सेस, ग्रीजेस, प्लास्टिक्स एंड टेक्सटाइल मटीरियल्स, टू द प्रिंटिंग ऑन द पेपर्स, प्लास्टिक्स एंड फैब्रिक्स। सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन कम्स, What are dyes? What is a proper definition of a dye? Dyes are the organic compounds normally used in solution to impart color to various substances like fabric, paper, leather, hair, drugs, cosmetics, plastics, and food material. Since dyes are organic compounds, so what are the criteria for a compound to qualify for a dye? It is, the compound or chemical should be able to impart a suitable color. It should be able to fix itself or capable of being fixed to the fabric. It must be fast and resistant towards water, dilute acids, alkalis and various organic solvents. It means it must have the ability to withstand washing, dry cleaning and exposure to light. Students, we have also discussed the roles of various groups present on the molecule of dyes as chromophores and auxochromes. For a detailed study of chromophores and auxochromes and also theory of color and constitution, the interested students can watch my YouTube video, Dyes, Color and Constitution. Now, we move on to our main topic for today, that is classification of dyes. Dyes are classified based on their origin, application and chemical properties. Dye manufacturers classify dyes according to their chemical properties, while dyers classify dyes based on the method of application. So we are going to study the following three classifications of dyes. Number one, classification of dyes based on the source of materials. Number two, based on the chemical structures, that is chromophores present on the dye molecule. And three, classification of dyes based on the methods of application. Let us study these classifications one by one. So, according to the classification based on the source of materials, what is meant by natural dyes? The dyes obtained from plants including fungus and lichens, animals, invertebrates or minerals are called as natural dyes. The cloths of Pharaoh of ancient Egypt have been found to be dyed with indigo. This indigo is a natural dye which is obtained from stems and leaves of indigo plant. Here are the pictures of indigo dye and the indigo plant. Other examples of natural dyes are alizarin dye, which is obtained from roots of madder plant. Logwood dyes, which is obtained from trunk of the tree and used to dye silk and cotton fabrics black. Here is one more interesting example, that is cochineal dye. This is the dye obtained from a female insect called as Coccus cacti. And here are the pictures of the insect and the dye obtained from these insects. So cochineal dye is also a natural dye. Similarly, one more dye, Tyrian purple dye, is made out of shellfish. And you must be knowing one more dye, that is Prussian blue, is an inorganic dye which is obtained from naturally occurring minerals. So these are natural dyes. Now, you must have an idea about the synthetic dyes. Synthetic dyes are the chemicals prepared in laboratories or factories and used for dyeing. As on date, majority of the dyes are synthetic because they are easy to use, cheaper, brighter, fast, have wider range of colors, and they can be prepared in large quantities in factories. Some examples of synthetic dyes are modern dyes, azo dyes, etc. Let us move to the more acceptable system of classification of dyes, that is classification of dyes based on the chemical structure or chromophores. This classification has many advantages. First, it readily identifies dyes as belonging to a group that has characteristic properties. For example, azo dyes means strong, good all-round properties and low-cost dyes, whereas anthraquinone dyes means weak and expensive dyes. Second and most important advantage is it is the classification used most widely by both the synthetic dye chemist and technologist. But this classification has its own limitations, as chemical constitution of dyes are so varied that it is difficult to classify them into distinct groups. So in some cases, a particular dye could be placed in one or the other group. Here are the main types of dyes based on the chemical structure or chromophores. Number 1, nitro and nitroso dyes. Number 2, azo dyes. Number 3, triaryl methane dyes. Number 4, anthraquinone dyes. Number 5, indigo dyes. Besides, some more types of chromophores are present in the structure of dye, so they can also be put in the following classes: azoic, stilbene, diaryl methane, xanthane, quinoline, methine, acridine, sulfur, thiazole, thiazine, endamine, azine, oxazine, lactone, thalocyanine. These are various chromophores present in the structure of dye. So a dye having stilbene chromophore can be classified as stilbene dye, or sulfur containing dye can be classified as sulfur dye. So these are various other classes of dye. Let us study them one by one. First, nitro and nitroso dyes. Nitro dyes, as the name indicates, these dyes contain nitro group as the chromophore and hydroxy group as oxochrome. For example, naphthol yellow S. Here is the structure of naphthol yellow S. Here NO2 chromophores have been highlighted with red color, and OH is the oxochrome here. Now, what are nitroso dyes? Nitroso dyes contain nitroso group as the chromophore and phenolic group as oxochrome. For example, gambene Y. Here is the structure of gambene Y, having NO as chromophore and OH as oxochrome. Students, as per one study, approximately 60-70% of the dyes used in food and textile manufacture are the azo dyes. Now, what are azo dyes? These are the dyes having azo group as chromophore in their molecular structure, and this group is present between two aromatic rings. Here is an example of azo dichrysodiene. You can see this N double bond N is the azo group which is present between two benzene rings. Azo dyes are largest used dyes. Almost 2/3 of the total dye consumption is the azo dyes. Example of azo dyes are tartrazine, Congo red, methyl orange, and Bismarck brown, and many more. The next type of dyes are triaryl methane dyes, in which a central carbon is bonded to three aromatic rings, one of which is in quinoid form. For example, malachite green. It is a dye used as a direct dye for wool and silk. What is a direct dye? We are going to discuss it later on in this lecture. Here is the structure of malachite green. This is the central carbon bonded with three aromatic rings. This means it is triaryl, and one of this aromatic ring is in quinoid form. So this is a triaryl methane dye. Other examples of triaryl methane dyes are crystal violet and phenolphthalein. The second dye, phenolphthalein, you must have used during your acid base titrations. The next are anthraquinone dyes, in which the anthraquinone ring is the chromophore, and OH, SO3H, NS2 are present as oxochrome. An important example of anthraquinone dye is alizarin, which is a red textile dye. The structure of alizarin, shown here, has an anthraquinoid ring, and OH groups are present as oxochromes on the ring. The other example is Ramazol Brilliant Blue R. Coming to next, indigo dyes. These are the oldest dyes used in the history of mankind. Indigo was a natural dye extracted from plants, but today nearly all indigo dye is prepared synthetically. You must have used jeans which are dyed with indigo. Indigo has carbonyl chromophore and indigoid structure, which is shown here in red color. It is used to dye cotton yarn, which is mainly used for the production of denim cloth for blue jeans. Here is the structure of indigo, and the chromophore, that is indigoid structure, has been highlighted with red. This C is double bonded with oxygen and in turn is single bonded with second carbon, which is bonded with third carbon with a double bond, and third carbon is bonded with fourth carbon with a single bond. Fourth carbon is double bonded with oxygen. This is the indigoid structure. So this is all about the classification of dyes based on chemical structures or chromophores. Now we will study the next classification, that is the classification based on methods of application of dyes. Now we move to the classification of the dyes on the basis of technique employed for their application. It is the classification used by the dyers, who are mainly concerned with the reaction of the dyes towards the fiber being used. As pointed out in previous slides, dyes have diverse chemical structures, but there are only four ways in which the dye molecule may be bound to the fiber. These are: number one, through covalent bonds; number two, through hydrogen bonds; number three, through ionic bonds; and number four, through van der Waals forces. The actual type of binding depends on the nature of fiber as well as dye. So on the basis of techniques of application of dyes, they can be classified as acidic dyes, direct dyes, wet dyes, modern dyes, azoic dyes, dispersed dyes, sulfur dyes, basic dyes, and reactive dyes. Let us study these classes in detail. The first are the acidic dyes. Acidic dyes are the sodium salts of sulfonic and carboxylic acids. They have water soluble anions. They are generally applied to dye nylon, wool, silk, and modified acrylics. Acidic dyes are also used for paper, leather, inkjet, food, and cosmetics. For example, methyl orange is an acidic dye. It is the structure of methyl orange. It is evident from this structure that it has anionic form due to loss of H positive by the sulfonic acidic group. So methyl orange is an acidic dye. Direct dyes, as the name indicates, these can be applied directly from a neutral or slightly alkaline dye solution to the fabric. These have high affinity for cellulosic fibers. These dyes contain acidic or basic oxochromes. Dye molecules are polar in nature, generally used to dye cotton, regenerated cellulose, paper, leather, wool, silk, and nylon. For example, Morcius yellow. Here is the structure of Morcius yellow. It is a direct dye. It means its solution is prepared in suitable solvent and fabric is dipped into that solution, and the dye molecules get binded with the fiber of the fabric. That's why it is called as direct dye. Coming to next, wet dyes. These are insoluble in water and applied to cellulosic fibers as soluble leucosalts after reduction in the alkaline bath, which generally uses sodium hydrogen sulfide. Onto the fiber, the leucoforms are reoxidized to the insoluble keto forms. Example of wet dyes are anthraquinones and indigoid dyes. The question comes, what are wets? Actually, wets are large containers, tubs or tanks used for dyeing, storing and mixing liquids, and used generally in industrial processes. The indigo was the first wet dye. Here is the picture of wets. In the coming slide, I am going to explain how wet dyes are applied onto the fabric. Indigo is an insoluble dye. It doesn't dissolve in water. Indigo has typical indigoid chromophore, so it is blue in color, but it is insoluble in water, so it cannot be applied on fabric directly. So how to apply indigo on cellulose or denim fabric? The answer is, first, get it reduced to leucosalt form by making it react with alkaline sodium hydrogen sulfide. On reduction, its chromophore is distorted and it becomes colorless. This colorless form is soluble in water and it can be applied on the fabric. So fabric is dipped in the solution of this leucoform, and afterwards the fabric is exposed to air. In presence of air, this leucoform gets reoxidized to blue color, and now this blue color is present on the fabric. And afterwards, the fabric where this blue indigo is adhered to it is treated with soap to redevelop the crystal structure. This is how a fabric, generally cotton, is dyed with indigo. Coming to modern dyes, these dyes cannot be used to dye the fiber directly as it has no natural affinity for the fiber. It requires a metal salt which is known as lake or mordant to get attached to the fabric or fiber. It is used with the help of salts. The fiber is first treated with the mordant and then with dye solution. This mordant forms an insoluble coordination complex between fiber and the dye. This mordant, along with dye, penetrates into the fabric. For example, aluminium or chromium oxide salts are used as mordants. Alizarin is a mordant dye which is suitable for wool and nylon. If we want to dye wool or nylon with alizarin, first the wool or nylon is dipped into metal ion solution, maybe aluminium, chromium ion or ferric ions. And after dipping it into metal ion solution, it is dipped into alizarin solution, and there forms a bond between alizarin, mordant and fabric. The color of the fabric depends on the color of the metal, that is type of the metal used. For example, alizarin when dyed using aluminium ion as mordant gives red color, whereas with ferric ion it gives violet black color. So alizarin is a mordant dye. Azoic dyes. These dyes are water insoluble azo compounds and produced in situ in the textile fiber by interaction of a diazonium compound with a coupling component. That's why these are called as ingrain dyes. These are applied via combining two soluble components, usually phenol or naphthols or aniline, impregnated in the fiber to form an insoluble color molecule. They are generally used to dye cellulose, but azoic dyes have toxic nature, so they are generally not preferred. For example, aniline, phenyl azo or pararet are the azoic dyes. Here is the structure of pararet. It means if you want to dye some fabric with some type of azoic dye, so first we dip that fabric in a solution of phenol or naphthol or aniline, and then we dip in the solution of other molecule. Both the molecules react at the surface of fabric and finally form a water insoluble azo compound, which is called as azoic dye. Next, the dispersed dyes. These are again insoluble or sparingly soluble in water and hence are dispersed in suitable reagent before application on the fiber. But these can form a colloidal dispersion in water, and the crystal structure of fabric absorbs the colloidal particles. These are generally used for the dyeing of synthetic fibers like polyester, nylon, cellulose, acetate, acrylic fibers, etc. Example of dispersed dyes are duranol, red P, pyrazolone derivatives. Here is the structure of duranol red 2B. The next are sulfur dyes. Here is the structure of a sulfur dye. As the structure shows, lot of sulfur atoms are present throughout the structure. So as the name indicates, these are sulfur containing dyes. They offer good wet fastness and variety of colors. The picture shows sulfur dyes having different colors. Sulfur dyes were first made in 1879 and are used mainly to dye cotton and rayon. They offer good wet fastness and variety of colors. But the application of sulfur dye requires careful plant transformation between the water-soluble reduced state of the dye and insoluble oxidized form. So they are also applied like wet dyes. But sulfur dyes are not applicable to wool or silk because these dyes have poor resistance to chlorine, which is very often used during the processing of wool and silk. Here is a sulfur dye. Its name is indigo wet blue. Basic or cationic dyes. These are water soluble dyes and present as colored cations in solution. These are applied to paper, polyacrylonitrile, modified nylons, and modified polyester. The principal chemical classes for basic dyes are triaryl methane, cyanine, hemicyanine, thiazine, oxine, and acridine, etc. Since some basic dyes show biological activities, they are used as antiseptics in the medical. Examples of basic dyes are chrysodyne and acid red. Here is the structure of chrysodyne, and it is present as a cation, and in solution Cl negative is made free. So it is present in the solution as a substituted ammonium cation. So it is a basic dye. Reactive dyes. These dyes have chromophoric group that reacts with the substrate or the fiber. Reactive dyes form a covalent bond with the fiber, which is generally cotton, wool, or nylon. These dyes show extremely high wash fastness. That means they cannot be removed by repeated washing of the fabric. Main classes of reactive dyes are azo, thalocyanin, formazan, and anthraquinone dyes. High purity reactive dyes are used in the inkjet printing of textile, especially cotton. An example of reactive dye is procyon dye. I am going to illustrate the binding of reactive dye procyon with the fiber. Procyon dye is stable in water and it becomes attached to the cellulose fiber via hydroxyl groups in weakly alkaline solution. The reaction takes place like this. Here is the structure of procyon dye. It contains Cl groups here and as well as here. These two Cl groups are substituted by OH group when Procyon dye is taken in weakly alkaline solution and the newly formed OH groups form covalent bond with the groups present on the surface of the fiber. So, during the dyeing process, a chemical reaction takes place between the dye molecule and the groups present on the surface of the fiber. That's why such dyes are known as reactive dyes. And since there is a covalent bonding between dye and the fiber, these dyes show high wash fastness. So, students, this is all about the classification of dyes. For a recap, dyes can be classified in three ways. Number one, on the basis of their origin. Number two, on the basis of structure of the chromophores present there. Number three, on the basis of method of application of dyes. We have discussed all these three classifications in detail with suitable examples. Here are the references used to prepare this lecture. Thank you.